Oh. Max, stay over. Is she sleeping, like, with her head on the bed? That'd be kind of cute. Yep. That is killer for your back, but hey. Oh, looks like Chloe's gone. Or is she? I can't tell. No, she's right there. She's still awake. Oh. Max, you are gonna wake up with, well. You are gonna have a sore back.
I cannot believe you fell asleep so fast. How dare you?
I know you were beat down after the day with me. And Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No. I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me.
You are a bitch in the morning.
It's the company I keep. Yesterday was such a blast.
It was great seeing you.
I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates, jumping and running through the forests again. It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit. Fuck. I'm getting my regular head pains. Can you pretty please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom?
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep the swag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. Like a pirate, right?
I'm on it, Chloe.
Oh, time to do some stuff. I don't know what photo opportunities are in here, but I'm... of course. Picture! Medical ventilator, Chloe. Okay, I'll be back with your thing, I promise. Oh, hi, William. I didn't really get to know you for the last 3 episodes, but you're a pretty cool dude, I hear.
Damn. This is just
for Jesus Chloe's Christ. Supplies. God, well, I'm just gonna say, you can tell that there's insurance tacked onto that, because that would probably be so much more, especially for, like, all the stuff she has in that room. Whoa, 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 whoa. Hey, whoa, whoa. Wow. Wait, I have... Oh, that's so gross! I hate you! She uses emoji! Aw, that's cute. Oh. Well, that's all my things, so... Let's look at this Eiffel Tower.
Bonjour. That's great they finally went to Paris.
But at what cost? Oh wait, I have a dialogue option. What with who? Hey, a water. A water bottle.
They gave Chloe their giant expensive HDTV, and they use her shitty tube television.
No, I don't think Joyce's tips will cover all this.
To think that our destiny is linked to goddamn car keys. Yep, that's the same graffiti from before.
That's the one you put there.
Shoot me now.
William, are you okay?
No change to spare anymore. Now it's back to cookies.
Okay.
Joyce is a food coupon boss.
Jar. I'll talk to William in a moment. I want to see everything that's down here. Real quick. Real quick, like.
Joyce and William never had a garage sale before.
I'll bet.
They're drowning in debt. Just to take care of their daughter. Such bullshit.
Oof. Alright, let's talk to William.
I'm not gonna say fucking. I'm not gonna say fucking.
They might get their own home taken away because of medical bills.
Just. I'm laughing because it's like, I'm gonna read this while you're working on it. Just like,
These whales are just a preview of the tornado to come. And the Prescott Foundation? Jesus. Rachel Amber is even missing in this reality. I guess I can't change everything.
Hey, William. Am I bothering you?
Why, yes, Max. I love going through bills. Kidding. How can you bother me? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. You look exactly the same. It's so cool.
Good. Or I'd be scared if I didn't look like me. Of course, you seem more adult now. So what's on your mind?
What's next? Let's do a Paris trip.
So you finally made it to Paris.
Oui, as they say. Not me, because I can't speak French. But it was a great experience, especially for Chloe.
I can see her loving it there. You guys rock for going on a family adventure like that.
She talked about going to school there, but that's not practical anymore. It's not fair, Max.
Well, I really hope my microphone's not picking up the... outside noise. Somebody's got their bass up way too loud.
Being around you and Joyce again is so nostalgic.
Very old school, as they say. I think it's great for Chloe to see you. Makes Joyce happy, too. So it's not all bad news in Arcadia Bay. Or is it?
Prescott family?
The Prescott family might be bad news. What do you think about them?
Evil. Next question?
Sounds like you know them well.
More than I want to. But Joyce has to work for those greedy bastards at Pan Estates. I don't even like to think about it.
Pan Estates? Does she not do the two wells anymore?
What do you think is going on with all of this crazy weather and animals dying?
Nobody knows, right? It is Nostradamus-type shit, pardon my French. But all I actually care about now is Chloe and Joyce. My family.
I was reading about that missing girl. Rachel Amber.
Oh, yeah, she went to Blackwell, right? Oh, poor thing. That's a real nightmare for a family. I get scared thinking about Chloe and that we might lose her someday.
Speaking of, it kind of sounds like she's considering things that we don't want to have her consider. So, I mean, it's kind of... I feel really bad.
I was impressed by Chloe's room and all the high-tech equipment.
You should be. We could buy a few mansions for what it all costs. Insurance helps, but I don't know, Max.
I know it must be hard on you guys financially.
These bills are more like crushing. We have to mortgage our home, and that's pretty scary. But we'll get through it. Price is always right. Get it? No?
I get it. But, I can understand where Max is coming from. It's not really a good thing to really joke about. I mean, it is worrisome.
I don't know how to say this, but I'm truly sorry about what happened to Chloe.
Me too. All it takes is a few minutes to change a girl's whole life. But she's alive. She's been a trooper.
Is she mad at me for not staying in touch? She should be. I have no excuse.
She was disappointed, but she knows you care. And I know how hard it is to process all this. It's taken us years.
William, I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll always be here for Chloe. Always.
I know you will, Max.
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything. It was so great talking with you again.
You act like it's the last time. And please, keep me from these bills whenever you want.
Mm-hmm. Will do. Alright. Time to go upstairs and get that needle! Oh, I thought a cutscene was gonna play.
Chloe's door doesn't have a warning anymore.
I wanna go inside. What happened to this room? Oh my god, it's empty. Aww.
A blue butterfly? I'm sure this is a total coincidence.
Yeah, it has to be! Fucking... What's this?
I never heard much about William's brother.
Hey, Bill. Sorry for not staying in touch since the accident. Work has been piling up on... End? I'm being sent to Salt Lake City to oversee a new parking lot. You have to go where the work is these days. I wish I could have sent you a bigger check, but you know the story. Money is nobody's favorite thing. Maybe I'll see you next spring for a visit. Kiss Chloe and Joyce for me. Hang in there, Billy. Your brother, Aaron. I didn't even know. Not that it was Shoes. Really brought up much.
Chloe always did love stomping around in her boots. Toys? I kind of want to open this and see what's in here.
I mean, why not? Just open it and then we'll rewind time like it never happened.
They bought crutches for Chloe, hoping she might walk again. Too bad Joyce and William can't get any help from the Prescott Foundation.
Dear Joyce, thank you for keeping me updated on Chloe's condition. I can only imagine the struggle you... Imagine the struggle you and William are going through. I'm so sorry that I can't help you with a loan this time. Like everybody else, I'm underwater with my own medical bills. Please give Chloe a hug and my best wishes. Oh, this is really hitting a hard point for me, too, because, like, I understand a lot of this, having done a lot of course, my medical stuff is not as severe as Chloe's.
I guess we stopped growing up together.
Because mine was just cancer. I mean, yes, cancer is a serious deal, but, like...
At least we never had to hide from Step Douche.
But, like, it is difficult. And gosh, it's really depressing for me to have to, like, play through. I'm glad that it's, you know, a major plot device in this game. Really, I am. It's just, it does really hit a hard point for me.
I'm still overwhelmed by this new reality. And I feel so guilty for putting Chloe and her family through this. I could give Chloe the choice of keeping William alive, but that would be cruel. But then I see that they're a family again, and who am I to judge?
But yeah, it's just like, I wish I could help out with my family a lot more with my whole medical bills, because, like, I get it. Whoa, Joyce is there.
Oh, Max, it is so nice to have you around.
But, like, my family busted their ass when I was in the hospital. I stayed in the hospital for a long time going through chemotherapy, and I luckily didn't have to go through radiation, but, I mean, there was a lot of stuff. I was signed up for a, science research for the cancer study as well, so that also took a lot out of me emotionally and, you know, physically, though. I think that also kind of helped with the reduction of bills, no. So.
I didn't realize how bad Chloe's injury really was.
Dear Mr. and Mrs. Price, as we discussed last week, Chloe's respiratory system is showing signs of rapid weakening. This accounts for her recent anemia and loss of breath. As a doctor, I am committed to her well-being, but I want you to understand the reality that respiratory failure is common in people with severe spinal injuries. Your daughter is one of the bravest, strongest patients I've ever had, and I'm proud to be working with her. I just want you as parents to prepare for any and all possibility. I believe Chloe should also be made aware of her changing condition, not coordination. If you would like to discuss this further, you have my contact information. But, I do like the fact that they depict Chloe, you know, trooping through it, making, you know, jokes about it, because that is a valid coping mechanism when going through such things. Because I joke about, you know, me going through cancer every now and again. I obviously don't make too many serious jokes, but, like, you know, we know how to have...
Things aren't as neat and tidy as they used to be.
She has no subtitles. But... not everything is, like, you know, hunky-dory and everything, and that's the thing. It's like, we don't want to be depressed, and it does confuse some of us why people get offended for us when people make jokes. And, you know, somebody can make some really awful joke about cancer, and I'll be laughing my ass off while somebody else who knows about my condition is like, yo, Jay had leukemia, and I'm just... you know, I'm like, no, it's fine. Like, you know, we need to have something to get our mind off of it, you know, and making jokes, having fun, while it's confusing for probably onlookers who are not going through the same thing, it's something that really does assist. So, I mean, obviously we're probably not gonna laugh if somebody is making, like, personal jabs, so, you know.
Look at them. They have no idea what's in their future.
I'm gonna be nosy. Is that okay, Joyce?
William is trying so hard. He's still awesome.
And yeah, I might actually cry a lot during this episode because...
that is such a sweet shot of Chloe. I wonder who took the picture.
Because, like, it really does. It's really something that hits hard for me.
Joyce used to hate smokers in the diner.
Well, I mean, she's probably smoking to get you know, calm herself.
Joyce is already a supermom.
Hi, Joyce.
Good morning, Max. Oh, you and Chloe are so much quieter now than when you were kids.
I remember. It's nice waking up in your house again.
Oh, William and I love it. Finally seeing you and Chloe together after all these years. After the accident.
I wish I was a better friend. I know Chloe doesn't get many visitors.
Oh, Max, you're Chloe's best friend for a reason. You're here exactly when she needs you.
I hope so. You guys do such an amazing job taking care of her.
We can only do so much, and she gets damn sick of her parents.
I can understand the
That's
feeling.
Why it's so important you came to spend time with her. Max, Chloe's condition is not improving. Her respiratory system is very weak, and she... Do you know what I'm saying?
Joyce, I'm so sorry you have to go through all this.
Bad or good, I embrace every moment with my daughter and my husband. This is what it means to be a family, and we'll always be one, no matter what.
Take the money from my credit card! Use it!
How are you doing, Joyce?
I'm doing the best I can, Max. I won't lie, it's difficult, but nobody said life was easy here in Arcadia Bay.
Do you know somebody named David Madsen? He, might hang out at the Two Whales.
Well, that was random. Yeah, he's a bus driver. He comes in sometimes. Cute, quiet. Why?
Oh, I was just curious.
You always were. Nice to see that everything doesn't change.
Plus, you guys have to work, too.
Bill and I have no time for ourselves. We're working more than we're living. I even had to take a part-time gig at Pan Estates. Ugh.
Do you know the Prescotts?
I know that Sean Prescott won't be happy until he owns everything in Arcadia Bay. Stay away from his son, Nathan.
Yeah, that would be a little hard to do because apparently when I reversed time and did the whole butterfly effect thing, I apparently became like one of his BFFs, you know, NBD and everything, but maybe I'm just doing this so I can like, I don't know, stab him.
So, what do you think is going on here with all of this eco havoc?
Maybe Arcadia Bay just wants to be left alone. I know the feeling. Honestly, I don't give a shit about too much outside our house.
I don't blame you, Joyce.
Except now we have dead birds and beach whales outside our front door. So maybe I should care, for Chloe's sake.
I have to tell you how much I love seeing you and William together again.
He's been such a hero through all this. Chloe and I are lucky to have him.
Yeah, I'll bet. William's still the same. Chloe and William.
Chloe and William seem like they still get along so good.
Yeah, those two are closer now more than ever. Chloe will actually listen to William while she usually ignores me. Oh, it's so cute when they gang up on poor old me.
You rule, Joyce.
Shit. Things would be different if I did. I like how you think, kid.
I better get back to Chloe now. It's good talking with you, Joyce.
You too, honey.
I'm still kind of curious, just like, fucking you just come in here unannounced. Didn't even knock. It's like, you know, this is their parents' bedroom. I would have gotten in trouble if I just walked into my parents' bedroom. Like, they would have been like, what the hell are you doing in here? Like, nothing. Not like I'm trying to get my confiscated electronics that you took away from me. Wouldn't it be creepy if somebody was just standing in the I was about to call the shower the refrigerator. What the fuck is wrong with me?
It's cool that Chloe uses natural medicine too.
Yeah, my parents actually had me use a lot of natural herbs and vitamins when I was going through my chemotherapy.
Nothing here.
bathroom looks almost the same. Just more medicine.
But yeah, I had like a lot of vitamin B12, vitamin C, vitamin D. I also had vitamin E.
Here it is. I never thought I'd be delivering morphine to my best friend.
There's also, for my mood swings, I had black cohosh, which is a natural hormonal balancer, so it's pretty good. Older. Let's hurry downstairs. Nothing else up here. I haven't seen any picture opportunities yet, so I don't really know what's going on with that. Can I go outside? Is this open? Holy shit, it is. Oh, okay.
The house looks so great.
Now that it's been painted.
William finally had the time to paint the house and fix up the garden. Look at all these dead birds. It's happening here too.
Yeah, don't pick that up. Hmm. Ooh, can I take a picture of these? What the fuck, man? Oh, now that I walk away, you're back, huh?
I'm sorry, Bongo Kitty. But you passed on before I changed this reality.
Yeah. Can I take a picture of this? No.
Chloe actually moved our drawing so she could see it from her room. Chloe. Oh, man. The swing is gone now. It must have been sad for Chloe when William took it down.
I'll bet.
I'm glad Chloe gets a room with a view.
Alright, well, I think this is about as thorough as I can make it. I haven't seen any picture opportunities, so we'll get back inside. And I can't take a picture of William. I can't. Maybe I can take a picture of this Eiffel Tower, like, if I get to a certain... No? No. Alright. Alright, we'll go. But yeah, this was the garage, once upon a time. So anyways. Oh my god, I'm so sorry I made you wait for so long. Here.
Finally. Give me the blue pill.
Oh yes, a Matrix. Sorry. Reference.
I'm nosy, but not precise. Go ahead and plug it right in. It's so easy. And painless.
Okay, but get ready to yell for your folks if I screw up.
Oh, trust me. I will. Of course, my pain just keeps getting worse. But you caught me on a good day. Max, I'm so grateful that I'm even able to hang out with you. See, I'm getting mushy. I'm already high.
You're so adorable. Do you want anything else?
Stop me if I'm being too emo. But can you grab one of the photo albums over there? I'd like to check out some old pictures of us when we were kids.
Please. My diary is like emo ground zero. Plus, Max Caulfield does not pass up a photo op with Chloe Price. Ever.
Good. I don't think there's anything in here that I can really get a picture of the teddy bear. Nope. Yeah, I don't think there's any photo opportunities in here whatsoever. Oh, look at the IV drip.
That must be her mighty morphine machine.
Oh.
No more bongs for her.
Oh, I get it. Mighty morphine. I can't believe it took me that long to realize she's making a Power Rangers reference.
Is that okay?
Perfect. Oh my god. Look how little we are there. We look like toys.
I remember that day by the lighthouse.
My dad was pissed at us. He actually tried to give us a timeout.
And you laughed at him. My dad would have banished me.
Really? This... You're not just gonna do it automatically? Alright.
Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance.
Hell yeah.
There's still time for you. Oh man, there we are making pancakes. I love that shot of us. It's hard to believe my dad took that picture only 5 years ago.
Literally seems like yesterday.
I wish it was.
Me too. This photo... Maybe I could...
Listen, Max. My respiratory system is failing, and it's only getting worse. I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out. So, I know I'm just putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along, and I will too. This isn't how I want things to end.
What? What are you saying?
I'm saying that being with you again has been so special. I just wanted to feel like when we were kids running around Arcadia Bay and everything was possible, and you made me feel that way today. I want this time with you to be my last memory. Do you understand?
Yes, I do.
All you have to do is crank up the IV to 11.
I don't know. This episode is so hard. I don't know.
Chloe, I really don't know if I can do this. I had another friend who wanted to end it all, and I did everything I could to try and save her life. How can I be responsible for ending yours? I mean, there's gotta be another way.
Max, you were there for your friend, no matter what. Now I'm asking you to help me the same way.
I want to help you, Chloe, but I think my help is hurting.
At least you have a choice. When you want to make a decision, you can just do it. Look at me. I'm at the mercy of everybody. For once, I want to make my own choice. The most important one of my life. Please, help me, Max.
No! God damn it, God damn it, God. I don't want to do it, but... Oh, no. Fuck. God, I get the feeling a lot of people are gonna refuse to, but it's like, she's dying, and this... I don't want to help her commit... I don't want to do it. But she's gonna be mad at me. If I accept, her parents are probably gonna be mad at me because they're like, well, no one else was in Chloe's room. And then I'm not gonna have a good time. No one's gonna have a good time. I'm not having a good time right now. Fuck. I can rewind time. I can fix this. So I'm gonna ease her suffering right now. I can fix this.
Chloe, I'll just drift to sleep, dreaming of us here together, forever.
I can fix this. I can fix this. There's so many options I took in the previous three episodes that mean nothing right now. I can fix this too. I can fix this too. I will bring you back, Chloe. At least I better.
Thank you so much. I'm so proud of you for following your dreams. Don't forget about me.
Never.
I love you, Max. See you around.
Sooner than you think.
I can fix this. I can't get up.
I'm sorry.
I don't.
Someday, Dad.
Why can't I save both of them?
The flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper. Hello? Hey, honey. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course, I'll come pick you up. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund? Keys, please. Aha! You can't hide from me forever. And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
Dad!
Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world-famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert. Max, you'll be here too, right?
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. Like you're never gonna see us again.
You don't even know.
I'm so sorry. I tried to make things different for you. I did try. I'm sorry.
I don't know exactly what you're talking about, but come on. You have made things different, like my whole life. You're my best friend. I've got you and a great family. What's to be sorry for? We'll be best friends forever. And when we grow up, we're taking over the world.
Listen, whatever happens, I want you to be strong. Even if you feel like I wasn't there for you. Because I will never abandon you, Chloe. I'll always have your back. Always.
This is the way it is. Don't tell me.